Hello my dear fourth class children, a very good morning to each and everyone. Welcome back to our social class students. As we in chapter 6, that is our heroes. In the previous class we discussed about the farmers, that we discussed the comic strips. The two farmers are discussing about the food grains. So what are the problems we faced after independence, that is in 1947? Okay children, today we are going to learn about a person. So the person name is Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, and we are going to learn, so what he did to our country. What he did to our country. Okay, I will read for you, listen carefully. Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, this is in Let's Find Out session. Okay, we need food to live and stay healthy. As you know, we need food to live and stay healthy. Have you ever thought how different food items like rice, fruits and vegetables reach your nearby market? Okay children, when you go to More and V-Mart and the food, what vegetable shops, so you do you think how these different kinds of foods will get to the shops? So ready, they already prepared or what? Okay, today we are going to learn about them. Farmers grows like wheat, rice, dal, fruits and vegetables in their fields. Okay, from where we are getting these all different types of food? We are getting different types of food that are grown by the farmers. The farmers are the persons who grow the crops in their fields. In their fields means they have the some places to grow the crops. Okay, some farmer they will grow the wheat, they grow the rice, and they some farmer they grow the dals, pulses, and some farmer they grow the fruits and vegetables, and they will bring to the market, and the market people will send to the different shops. The, for example, they will send to the More and the More supermarket, D-Mart supermarket. Now understood how we get the food? So directly we don't get the food from the supermarkets. Then who will grow the food? The farmers will grow the food for us. They are the people who grow the food for us. Okay, traders buy these crops from farmers and sell them in the market. So traders, they will buy, the farmer will go to the concerned trader and he sell all his crop to the traders, and the traders will buy the crop and he will give some money to the farmers, and the traders will distribute among the all different shops. What might happen if farmers fail to produce enough food? So what will happen if farmer will not grow the enough food? So what problem will face? Will face, there is no food for entire country. It is very difficult. Today we are eating 3 meals, no? If farmers will grow less crop, then we will eat only 2 meals, isn't it? Food will become expensive, and the poor who do not have enough money to buy food will die for hunger, die of hunger. Okay, if farmer will grow less crop, so what will happen? The food will become very expensive. Expensive means very costly. No, if the food is less and the people are more, so what will happen? The rich people who is having more money, they will buy the food and they will eat and they will survive. The poor people who doesn't have money to buy the food, they will die of hunger. Okay, then many factors like too much rain, too little rain and pests result in the less production of crops. Here, so why the farmers are growing the less crops means because, so sometimes in our weather, in the nature, it will rains very heavily. No, more rain also spoil the crops. That is the first reason to less production in the crops. And the second is if there is no rain at all. So rain at all means what will happen? The plants, the fields need water to grow, isn't it? If there is no water, so what will happen? The production of the crop will be less. and the pest. Pest means the insects and the what, the worms or will what they destroy the crop. No, sometimes the farmer will not get the enough crop to him. That's why they will produce less crop. So these are the main reasons of the less production of the crop. Okay, in 1943, so children, what happened in 1943? The production of food became very less in India. So in 1943, the production of so the farmers gave only the less production of food to India because of it might have been due to the heavy rains. We don't know what happened because of less rains, otherwise because of the pests, that is insects. India, and there was a famine in Bengal. About 4 million people die of hunger. So famine means karu. You call this karu. Karu means there is no food. So you ask your grandfather, grandparents, they will explain you what is the how they face the problems during that time. Understood, children? In the Bengal, the famine came in the Bengal. About 4 million people die for hunger. So many huge people die for hunger. Hunger means there is no food. Without food, can't we live? No, it is not possible. 1 or 2 days we can survive, but the third day we can die. Okay. In 1947, when India got freedom, food shortage was big problem that needed to be solved. So what is the big problem to India after independence? That is the food shortage. That is the food shortage. So India has to solve the first problem is the food. India has to solve the problem of the food. The population of India was growing on a very fast pace and more food was needed to feed the people. So the India is the largest, second largest population country, no children. So more people, huge people will live in India. So if there is the less food, so how the government will provide the food to the huge, more people and the less food. So what will happen? It is not sufficient for the people, no. So government has to think. So they has to solve this problem. But farmers were still using old methods of farming which produce less crops in India. So the olden days, the farmers, they used to go to the traditional way. Traditional way means they use the bullocks to plug their fields. All the tradition methods they are using. So that's why that is the one more problem to get the less production of the crops. Crops are also got damaged because of less rain, floods, pests and insects. Earlier we discussed, no, because of the heavy rains or because of the less rain, otherwise because of the pests and the floods. Okay, India faced another famine in 1965 as the rains failed. Again in 1965, India one more famine occurred. That is because of there were no rains in 1965. There was severe shortage of food in the country because of which food items like rice and wheat became very costly. So if there is less food, the cost of the product will be also increased. Many people died of hunger. The government purchased food from other countries at the high prices to feed the people. So what government did is, so government will not leave the people like that, no children. So they buy the food from the other countries and to feed the Indians. So children, I hope you understand about the food shortage in India. In the next class, now how the government solve this problem, we'll discuss. Okay children, goodbye.